Okay, so today we will just discuss about the normal ECG. Normal ECG has a P, then a Q, then a R, S, T, U. These are all the common terminologies used for the normal ECG. Here we all know the P is atrial depolarization. Anyways, always remember depolarization is systole, contraction is depolarization, relaxation is repolarization. Here we can see the atrial contraction, and ventricular relaxation. And somewhere here there is a superimposition of atrial relaxation, that is atrial repolarization. But atrial repolarization is a very weak impulse when compared to the ventricular depolarization, that is ventricular systole. So it is hidden somewhere here, which is not seen. And as we all know, the one of the important thing about atrial depolarization is the P wave in itself is not the sinusoidal impulse. P wave is actually the contraction of the atria. If the P waves are not there, it doesn't mean that SA node is not getting its impulse out. It may be that the SA node is getting its impulse out, but it may be obstructed from coming to the atria. By atrial contraction is not there, but the impulses may be there. So P, importance of P is that it is the biatrial contraction. The PR segment, this is the interval from the beginning of the P to the beginning of the QRS is the PR interval. The end of the P to the beginning of the Q is the PR segment. PR segment is actually the conduction of through the AV node, the atrioventricular node. So whenever there is a PR segment prolongation, it means that the atrioventricular node is getting a more than required decremental response. Actually, atrioventricular node has a decremental response, that is, it has a rate related decrease in the conduction. If you increase the heart rate, the conduction through the AV node goes on decreasing. That's how it maintains the actual physiological heart rate required for the heart. So after this is the initial dip, which is usually seen or may not be seen. Usually very small Q, that is very small dip is seen. Q, in a sense, whatever all the electrical impulses which are going below the baseline, or that in that lead these impulses are going away from the chest leads, or whatever the leads which is it is focused on. Like if it is in the V1, if this small Q means that in the septum the conduction is going and it is actually away from the lead which has been put in the chest lead V1 is put in the anterior chest wall. So it is going in the septum slightly posteriorly, that is through the bundle of His. Once the bundle of His conduction is over, it gets into the Purkinje fibers and into the ventricle. So once the ventricle is getting depolarized, that is contraction is occurring, the QRS becomes a huge R, and then there is a steep S, which is most of the time is present or may not be present and is due to the conduction into the posterior wall. The posterior basal wall of the left ventricle is the last to contract, and when it is contracting, the ventricle the impulses are going away, and then comes the ST segment. ST segment is the relaxation phase. Before the relaxation phase, the ST segment is a flattened impulse. The impulse is not going anywhere, and then there is a relaxation, that is ventricular repolarization, which is coming towards the lead where it is placed, and relaxation is also towards the lead. So T waves are upright, and in sometimes the U wave may be seen, which is the conduction through the myocardial, the M cells which they call, is between the epicardium and the endocardium, the myocardial layers. And the whole from Q to the end of T is called the QT interval. The end of S to the beginning of T is called ST segment. The beginning of Q to end of S is called QRS duration. So this much basic you should be knowing about the PQRST, and this is the basic lead, that is lead 2 or lead V1 only you will get this kind of ECG, and all other leads it will be changed according to the electrical impulses which we get. Thanks.